Hey, Star Wars fans, another Fly Guy Don't Knit figure review. This one is brand new, not in stores and not even out yet anywhere, but managed to get hold of this on eBay, and it is the Wee Kwee Skiffgarp Master. This guy's from Wave 6 of the Vintage Collection. Let me give you your usual close up, but don't get too close up, he's not a pretty dude. Again, it's one that is really well done, fits in with the vintage collection really well. Let me just give you a quick look at that as I turn around and we'll talk about it in more detail. Not a great deal to report on this guy. He's got a very weird kind of Klingon kind of jacket, but other than that, he's a good looking figure. Didn't exactly do much in Return of the Jedi, this guy, but a cool figure nonetheless. So if you've never watched our videos before, you can whack this up to high def and you can really zoom in and see this guy. But let me just try a little bit closer to let you see this and you can get a real look at him. There we go. So again, from Return of the Jedi, brief scenes, he has got a real ugly face on him. Awesome job by Hasbro in the paint. You probably can't see it on the camera, but there's a very tiny fleck of black in his eyes, and it really gives a very menacing look. The facial sculpt you should see there is very wrinkled and imposing around him, so it really does add to the effect of the kind of wrinkled effect that these weeklies have. Very odd looking head, which I've never really noticed before, because it's always been something the expanded universe of. I've never seen a side profile of these guys, but again, very cool. Great looking staff or skiff weapon that he comes with. Nice touch by Hasbro with the silver paint down elements of it. Just adds a little bit of detail rather than have those flat silver pieces that they come with. The paint work applied to this guy's, again, this kind of Klingon-like puffed up jacket is very good. Very weathered looking overall. As you can see, the difference on the jacket is a kind of cream colored with brown, and down the arms you've got this kind of dirty, yellowy, kind of stained, and really kind of weathered effect on them. Not much to report on the bottom half. It's just a case of fairly brown all over, straight kind of trousers that he's wearing, and boots with little straps on the bottom there, little leather boots with brown pieces over the top. So there's not a great deal of intricate detail, but there is a lot of detail as far as the weathering is concerned. Lots of leather-like pouches on his belt, huge one there on the side of him, and a working holster with a great-looking pistol, which I'll just take out for you in a second. And let me just show you what's going on with this guy. So there's the pistol. Oops. Again, great detail, nice silver touches. In terms of articulation, this guy has got, now he's got his braids at the back, which does again inhibit the movement, but he does have a fair a bit of room that you can turn his head. So it's a ball-jointed head. The shoulders, let me just take his weapon off. The shoulders have, again, because of this, as you'll see, the kind of limited movement that they have there, they are in fact ball-jointed, but again, you really just can't move them too much. It's a bit of a wasted feature in some ways. You can't move them too much, but they definitely are a fully ball-jointed shoulder. On the elbows, they are ball-jointed. This figure brand new, the packaging today, so my apologies. Well, I don't mean packaging the vintage collection. This came loose, but in terms of the package, this came. So shoulders, elbows, swivel wrists, and swivel waist. He has under this plastic-like skirt, it's swivel, you can just see it, maybe not, but it is swivel hips, I believe. Yep, swivel hips. Ball-jointed knees, and there's not much movement for it, but he certainly does have articulated ankles. The trousers limit some of the movement there, so there's not a great deal to move around. But in terms of the look and feel of this guy, he really does pack a punch in terms of the facial sculpt. The eyes, again, really kind of are not a good looking feature, very creepy. And he's going to look great on a skiff or in your Jabba's palace or some other kind of scene like that. But again, not even stores yet, but again, it's all over eBay. I'm sure many people, and I know many people who watch this channel, will probably have bought one as well, because we posted about this just at the end of January. So so there you go, Weequay Skiffguard Wave 6 Vintage Collection. Cost me shit just about $10. That's 10 US or 10 Australian dollars. And there we go. Let us know, what do you think? Weequays, any good? I did have one to compare from the Clone Wars, just to give you a quick look, but obviously there's not a great deal of comparison because they're very, very different figures. But both kind of ugly dudes. But yeah, the Clone Wars version and this guy are brothers. So there we go. Yep, let us know, comments below, or again on facebook.com, flyguy.net, and let us know what you think about this figure. See you then. Bye.